The Netatmo Weather Station is a great and geeky way to track the weather and climate in and around your house. It's good looking, accurate, and it plays well with Amazon Alexa and If This Then That. So the basic set comprises of an indoor and an outdoor unit. The indoor unit, that's this one, is always connected to power. It measures the temperature, humidity, noise levels, and concentration of carbon dioxide in your house or apartment. The smaller outdoor unit runs on a couple of AAA batteries, and you'll need to place it in a dry area that's away from direct sunlight. It records temperature, humidity, atmospheric pressure, and what I found most interesting, the air quality. That's the measurement shown here. It's the amount of 2.5 micron particulate matter in the air, and it gives you a rating of that number based on guidelines from the US Environmental Protection Agency. The basic set, these two, cost $180, but you can expand the system. Netatmo sells additional indoor units for $80, so you can monitor conditions in different parts of your house. There's also this wind gauge, that's $100, and a rain gauge for an extra $80. If you add all of these together, you're starting to approach a pretty decent weather station, and all of the extra information will appear inside of the Netatmo app. The app shows the outdoor conditions at the top and the indoor conditions at the bottom. You can scroll through the outdoor conditions to see the pollution, temperature, rain, and wind measurements. Now, this is all good stuff, but if you're a geek like me, one of the exciting features is the ability to feed this information back to Netatmo for inclusion in its weather map. The company says it's the world's largest weather station network, and there does appear to be stations all over the world. Take a look at the map. From the Arctic Circle, across the major continents, and down to the southern tips of the Americas, Africa, and New Zealand. The data is also fed to Weather Underground. Now, the data is anonymous, but the location isn't, so you can turn off data sharing if you want. The base units and the wind and rain gauges altogether represent a pretty decent $360 investment. So, how does it do? In TechHive tests, we found the Netatmo weather station to be very accurate. It was never far from the readings of a local National Weather Service station. All three of the outdoor battery-powered units were easy on power consumption, so you probably won't need to be constantly changing the batteries. Oh, and you can get an immediate readout of air quality at any time inside your house by pressing the top of the base station. The color will glow to indicate conditions. On the smart home front, the Netatmo weather station is compatible with Amazon Alexa, and there are a bunch of If This Then That recipes that enable you to do things like get an email when the temperature drops below zero, or change the color of Philips Hue light bulbs if the carbon dioxide levels rise too high in your house. TechHive rated the Netatmo weather station 4 out of 5. And the best thing, once you've bought it, there are no monthly subscription fees or other charges to run it.